Checking out Starbo.
Hello, dear stranger. My name is Leo. Leo Cornell. I'm about to tell you the story of a dead man's journey through... You know what? I bloody died. And afterwards, I found myself stuck in a hurry.
Man, there's no subtitles.
I've been dying to tell you this story. Literally. So, sit back, relax, and pay very close attention to my voice as I tell you how all of this began. It all started on a warm Tuesday morning in June. I was walking toward my boss's office as the doors ahead were slowly opened by his two valets, or as my boss George personally calls them, called all of us, his human robots. What an asshole, right? Anyway, as I sat down in the chair opposite my boss, he looked me straight in the eye and quietly said with a smile on his face, "Leo, you're fucking fired." At first, I was confused and couldn't really say anything other than, "Okay, George, thank you for this." But the moment George looked away and took a bite of his tremendously green apple, I said, "George, fucking retarded." As the smile on his face slowly faded, I happily left the room. A few hours later, I decided to move back with my beloved family in the Bahamas. So without letting anyone know, I bought the cheapest plane tickets I could find, packed my bags, and made my way over to the airport. I was going to spend the rest of my days together with my family, perhaps start my own company and just live in the present. Everything was going so well. Until I realized that The goddamn pilot was fucking drunk and high. He sang Do or Die while losing altitude and, well, as you can see, the plane obviously crashed and burst into flames. That pilot died instantly, but I could still feel the burning flames all around me as everything went. Then, I woke up. I had awakened from complete darkness, only to find myself stuck in a shiny blue room. Luckily, I was freed soon by the door slowly opening ahead of me. In that moment, I began a brand new journey, an expedition through unexplored corridors filled with familiar beauty that I occasionally stumbled upon. Thank you. Soon, something somewhat familiar but horrendous discovered me as well. I realized then that there was more than beauty to be found hidden in the corners of this new world. Soon, something somewhat familiar but horrendous discovered me as well. I realized then that there was more than beauty to be found hidden in the corners of this new world.
Soon, something somewhat familiar but horrendous discovered me as well. I realized then that there was more than beauty to be found hidden in the corners of this new world. Again and again I had been rescued by doors. Doors that led further down into the mysteriously blue world. The further I got, the more I started to distrust my surroundings, as they got even more and more unrealistic.
Thank you.
The disbelief I felt for my surroundings did not stop me from continuing, though. Quite the opposite, actually.
I'm here for you.
It wasn't until the moment I heard her beautiful voice, the voice of my wife Nora, that everything started to become clear. The butterflies, robots, trees, and messages. Hell, even the huge whale I once saw as a kid were all stupid memories from my past, and got me wondering if the world I had been strolling through the past minutes, hours, or possibly even days was completely shaped by nothing other than my own imagination. And if that truly was the case, could this all be a long, dark dream? When the plane crashed, I could have survived somehow and fell into a coma. That had to be it, I thought to myself. I'm stuck in a dream. once I started to truly figure it all out, I found myself back where it all started. At the bloody office. I could almost even hear George dropping that green apple in confusion as I once again passed through those dark corridors toward brighter times. Once I started to truly figure it all out, I found myself back where it all started. At the bloody office. I could almost even hear George dropping that green apple in confusion as I once again passed through those dark corridors toward brighter times.
Thank you.
After moments of pain and fear, I realized that I had been taking the wrong path all this time. Because if this was all truly a long, dark, nightmarish dream, why run from the monsters of the dark if they could potentially wake you up? So as I finally knew what had to be done, I began seeking for the darkness inside of me, which soon resulted in chaos.
Leo. Fucking fire.
It's gotta be the end of the game.
George, fucking retarded.
Fell way longer than it should have been.
Finally, I'd left those damn tunnels behind me.